Hey guys, so I got a few requests to do a comparison here between the iPhone SE and the latest iPhone XS here. Arguably Apple's nicest industrial design handset when it comes to the pocketability. You can't actually buy these anymore from Apple, they are discontinued now, but they still come with a very powerful processor, Apple A9, same as your 6S. And I've got to say, in terms of the feel in the hand, it feels extremely durable compared to some of these new handsets. And it's still being supported as well with the latest iOS 12. So let's see how it does compare here against the latest generation iPhone. So the SE did come with a very low resolution display, but it was quite decent given the, size of the handset. It wasn't massively problematic. So we have got 2 weeks since the Apple XS did release, lots of time for it to improve the boot up. And you can see iPhone SE showing it up here, booting on literally 2 seconds faster, which goes to show some nice powerful stuff in the SE. Just show you the software here, as you can see. So if we just go to here, you can see we're on the latest there, and this one latest. So you can definitely see the XS looks amazing in terms of the display technology. That is a major advancement. But how does the performance compare? So let's just open up a few apps here on both of them and see if there's any differences. So basic stuff looks very identical so far. Some of them even opening up a little bit faster here on the SE. You can't make that up, really. Honestly, if the SE does win, then that will be very shocking. So, XS a little bit snappier there on that one. I gotta say, I do love the way iOS does flow in terms of the smoothness. You definitely do notice it being an Android user generally. But you can see, the SE looks amazingly well, defined here in terms of the speed. Let's have a look at some third-party apps. Similar there. And the great thing about the SE as well is the physical button, which means you have literally no chance of, oh, faster on the right, you got no chance of getting lost in an app trying to look for the software-based escape prompt, which I think is a design fail personally. So that's where this annoying YouTube ad comes from. I'm gonna uninstall that. But I mean, you can see here, absolutely fantastic performance. I think the SE has become the new LG G2, the phone that will absolutely never die, even in 2020. Let's have a look at the speed test here. So, allow. So they're both on the same server. Start with the SE. Doors open. So what we really wanted from Apple was just a sequel to the SE, really. They had one job, was to create a sequel to the SE. The bezel-less display, very nice price, let's say 400 to 500, and you're good to go. And I think it would have sold like hotcakes, you know. But the XS is still going to sell like hotcakes anyway, because it's Apple. And the Wi-Fi is certainly its strongest point, I'd say. I mean, this is the thing which consistently performs fantastically. So you can see quite a nice benefit here. So look at the game load as well. See if there's any differences here. Yeah, so massive difference here. Obviously, iPhone XS 50% better performance for the gaming, apparently. So that is another area you might see it. We can see the SE is not that far behind, really. You know, still pretty decent here. And there are some places where you can actually still buy the SE. If you're in the UK, for example, you can get it from like third-party places. So it's not completely gone. So yeah, I think really with the XS, my time with it, I've noticed the only real improvements are the game load speed and the Wi-Fi. You know, that seems to be pretty much it. You can see that SE pretty much keeping up with everything here. This is a 32 gig model of the SE as well. I think you could get the 16 gig, but that was pretty poor in terms of storage. But marvelous performance here. You know, this is definitely becoming the new LG G2 unbreakable device here, from when, you know, they were very affordable. New XS versus the iPhone SE. If you've got any other requests, you let me know. Hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you in the next one. Cheers.